I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. So let's talk about last night's lucid dream. It starts in Italy. I've been to Italy in waking life, although the place that I went to was not anything like the place that I was in my dream. In fact, I could only call it Italy after I woken up and after I had thought about the dream, because when I was describing it to myself, I wanted to use the word Egypt, but the architecture of the dream was that of ancient Rome and modern day Rome. I was walking through a town and the buildings were mossy and lifelike, as opposed to the ruins of ancient Rome that we have today. It was kind of like the transition period between what used to be and what is. And I remember walking through these streets. They were cobbled pavement stones, kind of similar to that you would find in Harry Potter, or any London town for that matter. And as I was walking through the town, I saw a window, and the window was a shop. It was a nice fronted window with small planes of glass, not like what you would get nowadays, which is like a big window. These were all individual smaller windows. And on the other side of that window pane was a sign, an A4 sign, that normally where I'm from, you'd get those to advertise a job, new jobs in here. So I went and had a look. I just glanced over at the sign and read what I thought was going to be a job. What it actually said was, "You are not lucid." And I laughed because I thought that was a bit of a weird sentence, and I carried on walking. But it was after that initial laugh and the dismissal of what I just read, in which I thought, no, there's something more to this. And I looked around, and that's when I realized that the sign was actually an indication that I am dreaming. I was not lucid, but I should have been. So I became lucid, and I was walking around the town, looking at the mossy cobblestones on the walls, walking around, just trying to get a good feel for the place. And I knew that in my dream, I was kind of walking down towards the beach. So I thought I'd carry on doing that. And the one thing that I tried to do, that I've never really done in a dream, but I think that I should start doing, or I should get into, was calling out loud what I wanted the dream to do. So for example, I was losing energy in the dream. I was losing the power to revitalize the dream. So I put my hands up in the air, like that, and I said at the top of my voice, "More energy now." And I didn't know what to expect. I'd heard stories on the internet of all these different people doing this and the effects that they found after they had done that. And I know that I've rubbed my hands in the past together and it's created this really interesting effect of pulsing colors and red pulses into my dream of vibrancy. But in my dream this time, when I said more energy now, everything kinda went super overexposed. Like it was being injected with vibrancy and the world was being magnified to overexposure. It started with the sky. The sky started getting really bright, and then the buildings got really bright, and then it went back to normal, which I thought was cool. Never done that before. It's quite a good positive experience. So then I decided to walk down towards the beach. And in my way, on the beach, were huge glass panels, like huge, blocking the path. And they were like reinforced glass panels, and I couldn't break through them. And I tried to up my lucidity to break through them, but nothing was working well. So I decided to use what I know to my advantage, visualization. So what I did was I visualized breaking the glass, and then I'd punch it and it would break. I'd step through the glass and walk towards the next glass, and I would do the same it wouldn't work, so I had to visualize, and then I'd punch it, and then it would work. And I kept on going and going and going until I eventually woke up. There are a couple of interesting points about this dream, and it goes to show that what I talk about in these videos really do play an effect as to what happens in a lucid dream. For example, when I saw the sign in the window for "you are not lucid," this is an indication of a layer zero. This is when you don't know that you're lucid. You're not aware that you're in a dream yet, but your dream kind of throws you hints that you are in a dream. When I wrote my song, Layers of Lucidity, like 5, 6, 7 years ago, whenever it was, I used the example of a layer zero as you see the word lucidity clearly written on your bedsheets. And layer zero is the black sheep of the family. You don't know you're dreaming, but you do subconsciously. The dream throws you lots of hints and tips at your sleep. It's like seeing the word lucidity clearly written on your bedsheets. And I did in fact see the word lucid in this dream, which prompted me to check and question reality. But I wouldn't have been able to do that if I didn't take seriously the implications of the dream, implications of the word lucid, which is what I refer to as the tipping point, which I have featured in another video, where you need to take that plunge into becoming lucid, otherwise you'll be stuck with this barrier between you and becoming lucid. The other thing that happens in this dream, which I talk about quite often, is when you're trying to induce more energy into the dream, you can vocalize what your intentions are. And this doesn't have to be limited to like trying to get lucid or get more energy. It can be like, I want to dunk that basketball, whoosh, done. So you can do that. Vocalizing is a good technique. And the last thing I want to talk about is the visualization process of trying to do something, but you can't do it. I think the reason I was on a beach is because recently I've been talking about a dream I had a long time ago in which I was running, and I was running on sand and I couldn't run because it felt like I was stuck. So I was like running really quickly in the sand but going nowhere. But in this dream, I didn't have that problem, but I was still on a beach. But the visualization part came into play when I tried to punch the glass. No matter how much I tried, I just couldn't do it until I visualized punching the glass. And that's when I visualized punching the glass that it actually worked. You can use visualization techniques for loads of different things. And one of the most prominent things that you can use them for is to visualize a location or a person that you want to see or be at when you go around a corner. So you can be on the corner of a building, visualize what you want to see on the other side of the corner, and then walk around and it should be there. Visualization in a dream is a very powerful tool that you should use. And that's pretty much it for today. I just want to say that on the 31st of October, there's going to be a live stream. I'm not entirely sure what time the live stream is going to be. So if you're around, please be a part of it. And until tomorrow,